Chemotherapy is a treatment using anti-cancer drugs to damage cancer cells so they can no longer divide or grow. It works by entering your bloodstream, either by a tablet or capsule taken by mouth, a subcutaneous injection into the fatty tissue of your skin, a drip into your vein, or a needle into your spine. Your treating team will discuss with you the appropriate chemotherapy drug and form of delivery specific for your treatment. Throughout treatment, you may experience some side effects. Not everyone experiences all of them, but they may include fever and an increased risk of infection, nausea, the sick feeling in your stomach, or vomiting, bringing up your food, loose stools numerous times per day, known as diarrhea, or stools that are hard to pass, known as constipation, not feeling hungry or losing your appetite, temporary loss of hair, feeling more tired and worn out than usual, mouth sores, loss of sensation in your feet or hands, and forgetfulness or difficulty remembering things. These symptoms may worsen as your treatment cycle goes on, but should improve once it's completed. Talk to your treating team about your experiences, as they can provide suggestions for relief. Treatment can cause changes in your blood count, which is why it's important you have regular blood tests as arranged by your treating team. Red blood cells carry oxygen around your body. You might feel tired, cold, or short of breath when these levels are low. White blood cells help fight infection. These include neutrophils, which can become low during treatment and means that your body can't fight infection as well as usual. Platelets help to form clots to control bleeding and bruising. During treatment, these also become lower than usual, so extra care must be taken to prevent bleeding. You may at some point require a red blood cell or a platelet transfusion to top up your blood count levels, but your treating team will let you know if and when this is required. Although you may experience a decreased appetite and changes to your taste and smell, it's important to choose foods that will help in regaining strength. You also need to stay hydrated with at least 2 litres of caffeine-free fluids per day, unless your doctor has restricted your fluid intake. Small meals regularly or eating plain foods is better than having nothing at all. During treatment and while your immune system is compromised, additional food safety measures should be taken to reduce your risk of infection. A low bacteria diet should be followed by avoiding the following: raw or undercooked meat, poultry, seafood or eggs, including runny yolks, sandwich, cured, or highly processed meats, including those from the deli, unpasteurized dairy products, soft cheeses and anything with mold in it, and food past its best before date. It's essential to avoid contamination by safely preparing foods. Be sure to wash your hands, surfaces, and equipment thoroughly, especially after preparing raw meat. Wash and peel raw fruit and vegetables, as bacteria can live on the skin. Thaw frozen foods in the fridge overnight rather than at room temperature or the microwave, and then cook until steaming hot. Don't defrost and refreeze food more than once. Cook meat until it's well done. Only eat food that has been freshly cooked and served immediately, and use leftovers within 1 to 2 days. Cancer treatment can cause changes to your physical appearance, fatigue, and hormonal changes, which may all affect your sexual drive. Touch, cuddling, and gentle massage are ways to connect and maintain intimacy without having intercourse. Treatment can also affect your fertility, sexual function, or a developing baby, which it's important to discuss with your doctor before treatment commences. After treatment, it's important not to assume that you're infertile without your doctor arranging for this to be medically verified. It's safe to resume intercourse once your white cells are above 1 and your platelet count above 50. However, condoms are recommended during treatment to protect you from sexually transmitted infections, pregnancy while there's risk to a developing baby, and to protect your partner from exposure to bodily fluids that are potentially cytotoxic. Some women may experience vaginal dryness, for which lubricants such as KY jelly can be used, while men may experience erectile dysfunction. Notify your treating team if these symptoms are ongoing. There are some symptoms that you should seek help urgently for by attending the emergency department immediately. These include a temperature of 38 degrees Celsius or higher, chills, sweats, shivers or shakes, breathing difficulties, uncontrolled diarrhea, if you're unable to keep any food or drink down, or pain that you can't get under control with your prescribed medication. Some further symptoms should be reported to your treating team as soon as possible. These include a headache or stiff neck, a sore throat, cough or cold, mouth sores, rash or redness of the skin, swelling, redness or tenderness, especially around a wound, catheter site or rectal area, and pain or blood when passing urine. Your health service may advise you to contact your nurse coordinator, treating ward, or doctor for guidance on managing these symptoms.